Well, we can have a fruitful exchange now with John Hemmings, who is with us, and I hope for a few minutes this time, Director of the Asia Studies Centre at the Henry Jackson Society. John, good evening. Does President Trump know what he wants from these talks?
I'm not sure that he does. I'm sure at the moment his response has been to actually deal with a very fluid state of diplomacy. I mean, he's essentially moved from Twitter warfare to accepting peace overtures to actually having a summit on his hands. I think everyone, all three sides, the Chinese, the Americans, and the North Koreans, and even the South Koreans, all four sides, are probably surprised at the fast pace of this.
But the question is, what's going on now? Because it seems that he may be pulling back or preparing the way for failure. Is it significant that he has a new national security advisor, John Bolton, who may not want a negotiated deal with North Korea? Very much a hardliner, very much a hawk.
I'm not sure I would read that into the statement where he said he would walk out. My read on that was more that he has been criticized for not having a game plan. He's been criticized for perhaps going in, you know, the office of the presidency is not being respected. We're legitimizing the North Korean regime. So, you know, the very kind of traditional State Department approach in the last three American presidents has been to really use the office of the presidency in formal negotiations as a reward and within itself. I think it's pushing back at that. He's saying, I'm happy to be in the room. I'm not going to give anything away. He certainly is trying to show a bit of strength, and that's clearly within the context of his meeting with Shinzo Abe. So it sounds all tough, but my impression is it's probably more for a domestic audience.
Yeah, but the suspicion remains that there are those around him, John, who want these talks to fail so the U.S. can attack.
Yeah, I can imagine that being, you know, but have you seen anyone who's had sway over Donald Trump? I mean, I don't mean to be glib, but it's true. I mean, this man has gone through so many strong so-called advisors in the past. It's clear that he is his own master. I mean, I think John Bolton is certainly, can be a figure of concern for some and you know, rightfully so, a strong person to others. I think at the end of the day, it will come down to what Donald Trump thinks he wants to do.
And Kim Jong-il, rather, sees his nuclear weapons as a guard against the U.S. getting rid of them.
I think what's fascinating, what may come out of what's come out today, is a hint that China may well extend a nuclear umbrella as a security guarantee to North Korea. So if they give up their weapons, that they will be looked after. Because, of course, there's the Libya case, Ukraine case of other states that gave up their nukes. Look what happened to them. I think it would be very sensible. It's something that's long been desirable. The Americans have done it themselves with South Korea back in the 70s, and they've done it with Taiwan. You know, they offered security guarantees and made their allies, you know, slow down nuclear weapons programs or stop them completely.
Well, what a bizarre thought, offering Kim Jong-un guarantees.
I know. There's no moral... I tell you what, there's no, like, good choice in this. And this is what people say when they talk about North Korea being the land of bad options. You know, on the one hand, you're avoiding a nuclear war. You're saving perhaps millions of lives. On the other hand, you're guaranteeing one of the human rights nightmare states of the world. You know, I've been racking my brain about it all week. Like, what is the right choice there? And I think you could probably have an ethics class for the rest of time trying to answer that.
Because Kim Jong-un, as far as he's concerned, North Korea is already being treated as the equal of the U.S., and he still has his nuclear weapons.
Yeah, I think the nuclear weapon has definitely been very useful for him. And there's a lot of my colleagues and kind of, you know, North Korea wonks suspect that he will never give it up, that this is all part of the game, and that actually even the invitation to a summit was a bluff, and he was just kind of blown away that Trump, in fact, said, yes, I will do it, which is why he immediately had to go to Beijing on the train for advice and counsel and support.
In about 30 seconds, John, what do you think will happen?
Oh, good Lord, in 30 seconds, I hope that we will...
Well, the world could end in 30 seconds,
but
give us your more considered thought.
I hope that, you know, that China will offer some sort of guarantee, that the United States will give some reasonable assurances, that South Korea's sovereignty and Japan's concerns will both be considered, and that everyone comes out of a deal smiling.
John Hemmings, on that positive note, we'll end. Thank you very much indeed. Time is almost 5 to 6.